because you are here for an exam. I do hope you get cozy right now. If you need anything, like a pillow, a blanket, or whatever, let me know. Today we're going to be performing a very detailed cranial nerve exam, okay? And you're here for that, correct? Good. I am Dr. Sinan. I know I'm not your primary physician, but I am the neurologist here. And what we're going to do here is a cranial nerve exam. And I was looking at your report here, and it said that you may have hit your head and gotten a concussion. Yeah. So, I've actually had a couple in my time as well. And what we're going to do is, when you do hit your head, we're going to make sure that your brain, your face, your muscles, and your neck are all working properly, because sometimes if you get injured, especially on your head, we need to worry about some of the most priority things being your face, your neck, muscular response, eyes and face, okay? So get cozy, because this will be very long and very detailed, okay? Good. Now, before we begin with the exams, I'm going to ask you, could you please tell me your name and with full spelling? Okay, and that's with an I. Okay. My hand on the jawline. if it makes you feel at all dizzy or imbalanced, okay? So I'm just gonna put a little bit of pressure. 3, 2, 1. And are you okay? It's to throw you off. Now, let me know what you smell with this one. Okay. Smells a bit like fruit. Like the summertime, very good. Like citrus, very good. And what is this? Perfect. This one is actually orange. It smells exactly like a sweet orange. Very good. We're going to move on now. And this one is... Ooh, I love this one. So this one's a bit strong. I'm going to just let you smell it from right here. And what does that smell like to you? Okay, like flowers, like lavender. Very good. This one is English lavender, and it is a lovely smell. It smells like aromatherapy oils. Exam. something known as a pen light, focusing on what is known as a Snellen's chart, and going over the basic fields and visual fields of your eyes. I'm going to be sending you off to Dr. Starling, our eye doctor here, to finish this portion of the exam, and then you will come back and finish the rest of the exam with me, okay? Perfect. Now, we are going to send you to our office, and then we'll send you right back. Perfect.
Welcome. My name is Dr. Starling, and I hope you feel comfortable and cozy in my studio, and I am going to do horizontal lines. Four vertical. That's correct. Now I'm going to distract you with this distant target, okay? Which reflects light. And at the same time, I'm going to shine a little bit of light from the closer distance, okay? But you should keep looking at my nose. And just keep looking at my nose. You are doing great. Okay.
Results of your eye examination sent in from Dr. Starling. Yes, results are shared that quick. At the end of the exam, we will also give you a full set of what we found so that you are in the know of what we know. Okay? Good. And are you feeling okay? Great. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to quickly test your ears, okay? Change of hearing within the past month or so? Okay. And would you say that your hearing has changed throughout the years, or has it been affected since you've been hurt? Okay. So, what I'm going to use here is something known as an otoscope. And what it is a magnifying glass with a light. And I'm just going to gently take a look inside your ears, okay? If you feel uncomfortable or an uneasiness or an imbalance, I want you to let me know. Perfect. I'm just going to go first to your left ear, then to your right ear. Okay. So just stay still. Now, with this left ear, did you feel a slight scratch in your ear? Okay, that's good. That's a sign that you are the tool inside of your ear. Now, are you feeling any sense of imbalance, also known as vertigo? Okay, I'm going to check now the other ear. Also hear a similar amount of sound, or was one a bit louder than the other? Okay, so what I saw was that in your left ear, quite close to where concert, I saw a bit more inflammation, which can cause a bit of sound differences between the two ears. However, I would like to know if you heard a difference. Especially next to the side where you were injured on the left, is just a bit overcompensating for sound, which can be something that is common, especially next to the area where you are. Okay. What we're going to do now is use the tuning fork for a muscular assessment. And the tuning fork can be used to test muscles and reflexes, and that's what we're going to do. I'm first going to tap on the middle of your forehead with the tuning fork to test if your eyes blink and react to the pressure here. I'm going to move down to where I'm going to copy and do the exact same thing on your nose and right above your mouth. Then we're going to do the chin. Okay, so I'm going to test to see if you blink when I do test the reflex. So just sit as still as you can. Okay, and we're going to begin with the forehead. Let's go. I'm going to test it in 3, 2, 1. Okay, 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. And 3, 2, 1. Good. You blinked to protect your eyes each time, which is the perfect sign that we're looking for. Now we're going to test it right on the bridge of your nose, which is right there. Okay, let's begin. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. Very good. That reaction was a bit quicker than the forehead, which is perfect. That's what we're looking for here. Going to test right above the mouth now, between the nose. This area is actually very sensitive, and it's one of the areas that we really need to test for muscular movement. Might also make you smile or move your mouth a bit. So I'm just going to test right above the mouth. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Good. 3, 2, 1. Good. 3, 2, 1. Good. 3, 2, 1. Reflexes were good, and small parts of your mouth moved. Now we're going to do the chin. I'm actually going to place it right at the end of the chin, and we're going to test right there. It might feel a bit strange in your jaw. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. Okay. Very good. I'm now going to test quick reflexes with your eyes, and I'm just going to do it with my finger. What I want you to do is, I will do it with you as well. Touch my finger and then touch your nose, and this is a way to identify if your eyes are working with the muscles around your face to look and identify the finger, and it's also a way to test a bit of depth perception. Okay, good, let's begin. So just touch the finger. Touch the nose. Good. 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 Okay. Good. Good. And good. Good. And perfect. Thank you. Muscles around the face. We're going to play a game called Mimic Me. I'm going to ask you to make a couple of funny faces, mimic me, and we're going to see if all the muscles around your face can work evenly, and if the muscles are distributed properly to where it's functioning as they should. What we're going to do first is mimic the expression I make with my forehead. I want you to raise your eyebrows super tall as if you were very excited, okay? Super tall. I know it's funny, but raise your eyebrows. Very good. I'm going to put a bit of pressure on there, okay? Good. 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 Now you can relax your eyebrows. Good. Now I want you to furrow your brows like so, where you're causing a very significant furrow with the brow. Okay, I'm gonna put my hand right there as well. Just going to carefully just is very wide.
Okay, I'm just gonna get a bit closer when we look at that.
Opening your eyes very wide. Okay, and you can relax them now. I want you to close your eyes very tight. Yes, as if there was wind getting in your eyes.
Okay,
and I see the distribution of muscle between both sides of you closing your eyes is even. Perfect. You can relax your eyes now and open them.
Thank you.
Okay. Now, I'm going to ask you if you are able to flare out your nostrils. If not, that's okay. But if you can just flare out your nostrils. Okay, good. Now I'm going to ask you if you can give me a very cheesy smile. As big as you can make it without opening your mouth. Perfect. going to do the scratch and soft test. You can open your eyes as I explain it. One side of this tool is soft, like a little small cotton round. The other side is, as you just felt, a bit sharp. However, I'm going to just be scratching it. If you can give me your finger really carefully, I'm going to show you how much pressure I'm going to put. I'm just going to very carefully scratch it. As you close your eyes again, I want you to identify if what I'm doing is soft or a bit sharp. Okay? If it's very uncomfortable, let me know. I don't want you to be in pain. It's just a way if you can identify the two different feelings of soft and sharp. Okay? We're first going to do it around the area of your face, missing the part that's injured, and then we're going to get pretty close to the part that was injured. Okay. Now close your eyes. Good. We're going to begin now. Just gonna place this a little too close. So just stay calm. last but not least, I have a couple of verbal questions and comprehension questions for you. I want you to mimic the sounds that I make, okay? We're gonna start off with ooh. Can you say ooh for me? Yes. Go. Ooh. Perfect. And did you feel like you had any difficulty saying that? Okay, we're gonna go on to eh. Make sure your mouth isn't a smile when you do this. Mimic me and go eh. Good. Did you find any difficulties with that? Okay, now I'm gonna ask you to go necessarily agree with. Someone else could be like, oh, don't get angry at that. Just Hope you feel better soon, and we hope to hear from you soon that you are feeling better, okay?